In this video, we'll look at edge detection instructions in PLC programming. We'll talk about what is it, why it's important, and how to use it in a project. You will see different examples and how to solve common problems using these instructions. If you are interested in PLC programming, subscribe our channel and smash the like button. Let's get started.
In this module, we are going to look at edge detection instructions. Firstly, I will describe following instructions detecting falling and rising edge. Then I will go to practical examples. We are going to see how to use those instructions in our program. What is signal edge detection and what is it for? So far, we have used steady state signals like logical 0 or logical 1. In some applications, it is necessary to detect the transition. In other words, transitions between these states. For instance, we need to capture the moment of transition from state 0 to logical 1 or from state logical 1 to logical 0. If you want to detect the rising edge of the operand assigned to this instruction, you can use the contact instruction marked with the letter P. This is a special kind of contact that works as follows. Here we have connected the signal from the PLC input above the contact. Contact begins to conduct when the transition appears at the input of this contact. It gives the signal from the left side of the ladder rungs to the right side. That is the transition from logical 0 to 1. Now, very important information. This contact is closed for one program cycle only. It means that when there is the transition from 0 to 1, this contact is switched on. In the next user program call, this contact is opened. Below the text, you can see the timing charts of this instruction. At the bottom of this signal, we have the input signal waveform. The address of this input is I0.0. When there is the transition from logical 0 to logical 1, contact is closed. Next, the signal I0.0 takes the value of 1. Next, there is a transition to logical 0. Only the next transition from 0 to 1 causes the contact to be switched on. As you may have noticed, we need to add a bit of memory to our edge detection instruction. Bit of memory stores information about the state of variable in the input from the previous one cycle. How it works in practice. With each callout of edge detection instruction, the value of the variable is compared to the value of the bit of memory. Then, the value of this variable is written to the bit of memory. Now let's move on to the falling edge detection instruction. The instruction works pretty the same as rising edge detection instruction. At the top of this instruction, we specify the variable and we would like to detect the edge of this variable. Below, there is a memory bit that helps the PLC to detect an edge. When we have a transition from logical 1 to logical 0 at the input, the contact will be closed. On the timing charts below, you can see three transitions. Here we have first transition, second transition, and third transition. Similarly to the previous instruction, this contact is closed for only one cycle of the PLC. Okay, now let's move on to an example. I opened the project template. I use here set reset flip-flop with dominant reset. This simple program implements the motor start-stop function. You can download the project template down below this video. Open the project and start work with me. Okay, let's go to project tree and to PLC tags. I will click on show all tags. Here I define three buttons. First button is X start on zero address. Next I have X reset and X stop. I also defined one output. This is output for motor. Next, I have two memory bits for set and reset our program. Okay, let's go to main program. I have downloaded the program to the PLC simulator. Now I will turn the monitoring on. Let's imagine the following scenario. We have two buttons, start and stop. Press on the start button to turn on motor. Next, click on stop button to stop the motor. What will happen if I turn on the motor and the start button contact is damaged? I will turn on this bit. So it means that when I pressed on the start button, then I pressed off the start button, physical button's contact still conducts. Okay, so when I press on the stop button, the motor will stop. In this moment, the stop button is still pressed on, but when start button is damaged, after releasing the stop button, the motor will start automatically. It could be a dangerous situation and you can expect that in your application. How we can write the ladder program to avoid this error in the future? Okay, I will modify this program, so I will turn off monitoring. On this course level, you know how to use edge detection instructions. We can use this instruction for start button. Let's click on start button. And here you have drop-down list. Here you can find a few types of contacts. Just choose contact marked with letter P. This is the rising edge detection instruction. You still need to assign a memory bit as I described in my presentation. So here type just M0.0. Click enter on keyboard. Now I will download the program to simulator. Let's analyze the program in this configuration. I will press on the start button. The rising edge of a signal is detected. As you may have noticed, I still pressed on the start button. There is a blue dashed line to the right of the start button. It means that this contact does not give a signal to the input of the flip-flop instruction. Now I will press off the start button. Next, I will press on the stop button. The motor is off, so the program works fine. Now I will simulate the start button error. Okay, so I will turn on this bit. In this scenario, the start button contacts will get stuck closed. In another technical words, this is contact welding. Let's test this program. Press on stop button. Motor is off. Go to start button. Press on this button. Motor is on. Click on stop button. Motor is off. As you can see, the use of a contact with the detection of the rising edge in the case of the start button allowed to eliminate the negative effects of failure in accordance of physical contacts welding of the X start button. Now I will show you an example application of falling edge detection. I will use contact marked with letter N. Rising edge detection is often used in triggering a start cycle of a machine. However, the falling edge is applied where the system needs a reset. You can use that in safety circuits where the standard specifies that the machine may be repowered when the system reset button is released. We will simplify safety system for the machine. You should know that the safety system is more extensive and requires appropriate additional safety modules. We can program it in TIA Portal Safety Advanced, but here we are going to learn and we can simplify the case. Okay, let's go to Project 3 and click on Show All Tags. Here we are going to add one more input. Right mouse click here and click add row. We are going to add X, E, stop button. As you can see, this is fourth input, I0.3. And we are going to add one more memory bit, X, S, stop bit on the next address. Let's go back to the main program, turn off monitoring and add here another network. Right mouse click, insert network. Okay, let's expand standard library. Here we have bit logic operations folder unfolded. We will use RS flip-flop, just drag and drop this block to the second network. Here we have one dominant input marked with S1. Click on it and add normal closed contact. Here we will add XS stop input. Okay, click enter. And here add XS stop bit for this flip-flop instruction. On the R input, add here normal open contact, and here we will use X reset button. In addition to that, I will also insert the X stop bit in parallel to the X stop signal. So I will add another branch here, then add normally open contact, and here the end of the branch just drag to the R1 input of SR function block. Then just add X stop bit here, X stop bit. Okay, I need to put networks in the right order. Firstly, the PLC should check the signal of the safety circuit and then turn off the motor. So just swap networks, just drag network 2 and put it here. Now it's time to introduce another concept. So far, all buttons we have used in project are simulation of physical buttons with normally open contacts. So by pressing that physical button, we pass a high state to the PLC input. It is a good practice to use a physical normally closed contacts for a control system of an industrial machine.
Okay, that's all for this YouTube video. The whole video with edge detection instructions you will find on our ControlByte platform for PLC programmers. If you want to sign up for this course, you will find the link down below this video. See you later.